What's up everybody, I'm back and in this video we're going through my 11 step guide to selecting the right 3D printer for you. It's coming up to that time of year where you could be buying something for Christmas, a gift for yourself, or maybe for somebody else. And choosing the right printer is especially important considering how expensive they are. So without any further ado, let's get into this. Step number one, don't buy a 3D printer. This might sound like an odd piece of advice, but don't rush into buying a 3D printer. Many of us get into this with rosy colored glasses, and we don't necessarily know what we're getting ourselves into. So don't rush out and buy a 3D printer. The first thing I would look to do is start learning CAD applications so that when you do get your 3D printer, you can take full use of it. I would suggest utilizing one or more of three options that you have available to you. Number one, ask a friend that you know has a 3D printer to be able to print on their machine. Get some experience using their machine before putting your hand in your own pocket. Option number two, if you have a makerspace nearby, you can potentially use a 3D printer that they have there available, and you can get a familiarity again without having to spend any money on the printer itself. You probably will have to pay some fees to the makerspace to use the equipment, but that's a lot less than actually putting your hand in your pocket and buying the printer outright. The third option here is to use a print on demand service, such as Shapeways. Here you can upload your files that you want to print, select your materials, you get a quotation on how much it's going to cost to produce that item, and then you have it shipped to your door. This leverages all the experience you potentially gain from using CAD applications to design your own STL files and having the versatility of having things shipped to you. Given the current conditions that we're all in globally, that's potentially a good option for a lot of people. Step number two, set a budget. 3D printers are not cheap. They range from a couple of hundred to several thousands, if not tens of thousands of universal money units. Seeing the bright lights and shiny shinies of 3D printing can be a little bit of a rabbit hole, and you need to have a point where you will stop, because not everybody has a bottomless pocket that they can delve into to buy whatever printer they want. Step number three, identify what you're going to be printing. 3D printers have different volumes and use different technologies to produce the 3D print itself. So having a good understanding how you're going to use this printer will be a guiding star as to which printer you're going to select. For most hobbyists, there's typically two choices of printers that you're going to go for. The first and most common is fused deposition modeling, where you have a reel of 3D printing filament which gets pushed into the 3D printer and injects onto the build plate, building layer by layer. The second is SLA or MSLA, depending on the type of technology used inside of the printer. And this is a resin-based technology. The raw material comes as a liquid, and it uses light to solidify that liquid to produce the model layers. This type of technology can create some seriously high detail and quality prints. But the disadvantage is we are limited on build volume available for these types of machines. Also consider how large the items you're going to print will be. Ultimately, you're going to be limited by the build volume of your printer, the maximum size object it can actually print. You may need to get creative with your 3D prints and slice these things down into a smaller build volume, combining them to make larger objects. Step number four, identify what material you want to use. 3D printers have a variety of different materials that you can print with, ranging from entry-level materials such as PLA, which are very easy to print, right the way through to composite materials, which take advanced techniques in order to print well. Your 3D printer may need to be modified to print some of these materials. For example, composite materials are known to be quite abrasive on the nozzle of your 3D printer, so upgrading to a wear-resistant nozzle will make sure that your printer prints reliably for longer. Flexible materials such as TPU may also require a different means of feeding the filaments. Direct dry 3D printers are more suitable for printing flexible filaments as they have a more constrained filament path than a Bowden style printer. It's not to say that you can't print flexible filaments on a Bowden style machine, just means it's a little bit more difficult. Step number five, consider the space that you have available to put the printer in. The environment your printer is in is quite important, going from the ambient temperature and moisture content of the space that it's in to the physical space the printer will take up and any noise that it might generate while it's in use. As your 3D printing experience increases, you will endeavor to print more and more complex items. Typically, this means longer print times, and it's not unusual to see print times in excess of 24 hours. If you live in an apartment or you have a house adjoining to your own, you might need to consider your neighbors, as a 3D printer can potentially be loud and it might be heard through the walls. Running a print 24/7 is probably gonna make a few people upset. Give consideration to printers which run quieter than others, or if your chosen printer is known to be noisy, then think of options that you've got to silence it or reduce the noise that it produces. This could be as simple as a concrete paver underneath your printer to placing it in another location in your home. If considering a resin-based printer, you also have to give consideration to what else is going on in the room. MSLA printers are known to give off fumes, which can be unpleasant if not toxic to somebody in the room. So ventilation may be required, or you may need to vacate the room that it's in while in operation. Step number 6, you now have to decide, are you going to scratch build a kit, or buy a printer that is good to go, also known as turnkey. A scratch build printer is where you investigate all the materials that you need, buy them from the various different suppliers, and then you assemble based upon your design. This method is the most labor intensive and technically challenging. So if this is the first printer you'll ever own, this probably isn't the solution for you. The pros to scratch building is you intimately know the ins and outs of your printer because you made it. Once you've built a scratch build printer for the first time and have it working successfully, you'll never need technical support on a printer again. So if it doesn't work, it's on you. Kit builds come in two different categories. One is a full-blown kit and one is part assembled. Like scratch building, you have all of the components that you require to build the printer. The design work is done all for you. The kit will come with detailed instructions on how to assemble the printer, and very often the manufacturer will have technical support for anybody experiencing any problems. You will still need to put the printer together and ensure all the nuts and bolts are tightened correctly. There is a level of technical competence required to put a full kit system together. Some manufacturers opt to provide a partial kit solution. In this scenario, it requires a reduced number of items to be connected together before you have a fully assembled printer. The last option in this category is the turnkey option, where the 3D printer comes fully assembled. It's a simple case of unboxing, plugging it in, loading it with the material that you're going to print with, leveling the bed, and then starting the print. This is the least involved option, as everything is fully set up, ready to go out of the box, with minimal tweaks such as bed leveling, the only things that need to be done. This option is probably the most expensive. Stick around to the end of the video and I will give you a number of manufacturers that sit in the kit, partial kit, and full turnkey solutions for you to have a look at. Step number 7, create a short list of 3D printers that you're interested in buying. It's really important that you select the number of printers that you're interested in buying so you can look at the different options that you've got available. There will be pros and cons to all printers, and it's about trying to identify the pros that you want to leverage and the cons you're willing to live with. Step number 8, do your homework. Once you have a short list of printers, you really need to do some research around the pros and cons. Look for reviews for these printers. Zoom in on all the things people are saying that are positive about the printer, but also look at all the things people are saying negative about the printer. There is a bit of judgment needed when reading these types of comments. Some people like to complain about really minor things. Other things could be really, really important to take note of. Weighing up the options, you then need to select from that list which printer you're interested in purchasing. Step number 9, find a reputable supplier for your 3D printer. A lot of 3D printers are internationally produced, potentially are not coming from your country of origin. Finding a reseller local to you helps in the event of any technical issues that you may have with the 3D printer or any returns that you may have. Very difficult to ship things overseas or talk to a technical department that doesn't speak your native language. Buying direct from overseas, however, has its advantages, as very often the printer will be cheaper. The question you have to ask yourself, are you willing to live with any issues that you have with that printer should they arise, or can you resolve those issues yourself? Step number 10, find a material supplier. There are many different types of materials for both FDM and resin-based printers. So finding a supplier or suppliers of these materials is important. If this is your first 3D printer, experiment with the different types of brands and suppliers of filament until you find one that works for you. The difference between success and failure could be changing brand of filament. Step number 11, join online support groups. The internet is full of groups of people who are avid fans of a given printer. Some of these people know these printers inside and out. They will modify their printers, they will share their information. Effectively, they're super fans. Join these groups and ask questions about the printer that you're about to buy and find out whether or not there's any feedback these end users may have that could either influence your decision to buy positive or negatively. Equally, if there's any problems that you experience with your printer during the process of using it, you have a support group to fall back on outside of the manufacturer that can potentially help you. I'll give you a number of brands that fit into the kit, part kit, and full turnkey solutions that we talked about previously. A reputable company that makes kit-based printers is Prusa. Prusa printers are based in the Czech Republic and they make excellent quality printers. Some of these kit printers offer auto bed leveling, skew adjustments in case there are minor defects in the way that you've put the printer together, multiple materials, and they also send candy in their printers. A manufacturer that I like for part-built kits is Creality. I own three Creality printers, the CR10 V1 and two CR10 V2s. So essentially, the printer comes in three parts. You have the main control box with modular cables to be able to connect to the motors, the bed assembly, which has all of the electronics, heater, all completely assembled. And then you have the gantry or the Z-axis, which also has the X-axis completely assembled. All it requires from these printers is a number of screws and bolts to attach the Z-axis to the bed assembly, a connection of the wires from the control box to the motors and the various sensors on the machine, and you're pretty much good to go once you've loaded your material in. A turnkey solution will probably come from a company like Ultimaker. So they have a full printer range of different sized build volumes, ranging from the hobbyist entry level right the way through to something which is more semi-industrial. These are probably on the upper end of the price range, but you get what you pay for. It's also worth noting that MSLA or resin-based printers all come as turnkey solutions. I've not seen any kit versions of these printers, and to be quite honest, it's probably worth staying away from any kits at this point of your 3D printing journey if this is the first printer that you're getting. Now you follow this 11-step process, you should know what you're going to be printing, what you're going to be printing in, your target machine, and how you're going to get support. So as you can tell, I'm really passionate about digital fabrication. Pop in the comments what you're making with your 3D printers. Don't forget to like and subscribe this video. I'll catch you in the next one.